In this video, we're going to install loose tube cable into a FDC08S closure. This particular model ships with a single E-cam, double E-cam, and a tray. And here's the closure. I'm going to open this up. It also has instructions for each one of those. This camming mechanism is what holds it together. See that right there? It comes pre-installed with lubricant here. So just keep that in mind when you start messing with this thing. And here's the inside of it. It's like a normal dome closure on the inside. I'm going to close it back up and set all this to the side. We'll start with the double E-cam. So I've already accessed 6 feet, 72 inches of this cable here. So one instruction will tell you 96 inches is the max. Depends upon the closure. It could be 72 inches. I'm comfortable with 72. But the first thing we're going to do is take apart these 3/8 inch sockets. The next step we're going to do is we're going to measure the diameter of the cable to figure out which of the components we're going to use. So you take the back of this sticky, peel it off, get it lined up pretty even with the radius of the center of the cable there. Make sure you don't leave any slack. Roll all the way around, pull it tight. Just like in the instructions, you'll see that this line here matches some of these items here. So this is Mastech length. The first one's Mastech length, which is the tape here we're going to put on here. And then the next one are your little clam pieces. This particular one lines up with 2 + 3 + 5. I'll explain that in a moment. And then the Christmas tree, the washers, if you will, on the Christmas tree there, is 0.6 to 0.7 inches or 15 to 17 millimeters, which is labeled on both sides of that thing. Okay. With that in mind, I have a 2 + 3 + 5. There's four of these, one for each side of the two cables. On the back of these, near the nub on the top, there's a number. This is a number 7. We don't need that one. Number 3, I do need this one. 2, I do need. 5, I do. So 2 + 3 + 5. The rest of these are not needed. I'm going to set those aside. Now these go together with the smallest on the inside, and there's a little hole on one side and a nub on the other. So the 2's on the inside and the 3's and the 5. And that goes inside of here. Like that. Now I'm going to do one for each side and for this side. So we just put these together. This is number 2, number 3, and number 5 set together for the end. Just set those aside. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and scuff the end of the cable here about 2 to 3 inches. You just want to take your tape and scuff right here back and forth like this. Don't go this way. That just gives a place for water to come in. Go around it like this. So we've got the cable scuffed. You're going to mark approximately 1/2 inch from the end. A mark. This is where your washer is going to go. Now, earlier when we used our tape, our measuring device over the end of the cable, we found that .6 and .7 was our washers. Now these are your washer trees. Let's just grab one. I'll show you. One side has inches. This is the .7 to .8. The other side's millimeters, 17 to 20 millimeters. There are 4 sets of these. So the ones I'm looking for are .6 and .7, and I need 4 of them. These have a little groove inside. You take your side cutters and cut that. If you're doing end access, you don't have to do that. You can just slide it over the end. But these, you take them and kind of twist them like this to get them over the cable. Earlier, we measured with the cable, and one of the numbers that we picked out was the length of the Mastech. And the Mastech tape is in this wrapping here, 13.5 inches. I'm going to measure that out right here. I'm going to cut just a little bit off the end here. I discard that portion. Now, go ahead and cut these at an angle. Like that. Now, what you're going to do is wrap up against this line you just made. Keep it nice and tight on top of each other, pulling it firm but not stretching it, just pulling it firm. Now one washer is going to go on that side, another washer will go on that side. So the next step is to take this Mastek rope and put it on the inside of this side of the double E-cam. There's a path right here, and it goes underneath here, down against the bottom, and back out the other side. I like to push down here, pull up on that, and just kind of put this down into that groove. And that part's done. You want to make sure you get these in the right way, because this stuff sticks pretty well to us. One of these is slightly offset than the other, so that these washers don't bump into each other, but essentially put this in here and make sure you've got the washers tight before you do it, because once it touches this other Mastek, it doesn't want to come apart. So I'm going to do one side. I'll do the other side. And the next step is take this smaller portion. It goes on the top where the three screws are. Holding that in place right there. Longer bolt goes in the middle. And you have two of the same size, and those are the same size as the other three on the other side. So you really have five short and one long. And then just get them started. I don't have a torque wrench with me, but this one's spec'd at 30 inch pounds. It's not a whole lot. It's about, you know, a little more than 2 foot-pounds. So I'm just going to snug it up. All right, so that's holding everything in place. I'll put the outside portion on. This portion right here, these three holes go over these three right here. You can reach in there and tighten those with those if you want to. But this goes right over the top. Line it up over these right here, and then put these three bolts in. These bolts are torqued to 60 inch pounds, as you see in the instructions. Just so you know, what you're doing is you're essentially compressing that tape, and it's filling the voids, so it's spreading out, so you do need to torque this down. Now you've built your double E-cam. Last thing I want to do here is strain relief. This is like any other strain relief. I'm just going to take these two dog houses off, trim this up so it goes underneath it, and get those nice and tight. Now that we've assembled our double E-cam, I want to go ahead and put it into the closure. First thing I want to do is put some silicone on this seal, put it into the closure, and then I can slide this in here. So I'll take the silicone, put a little bit on the outside. I'll spread that out with my fingers. This provides lubrication as well as sealant. This fits into this groove right here on the inside of the outside of the closure here. It snaps into place. It stays there. I like to put a little bit on the outside of that too, right here. I'm going to pull the dome off the back. Set it aside. I'm going to take the double E-cam with the strain relief hardware facing down. make a loop in the end, being careful not to kink your buffer tubes. Slide it in the slack area. And when you come to this point here, you want to try to get these guys right here, these little clamps, lined up before you get them too far in here. You're going to have to back these off if you need to. Take your 3/8 inch socket, tighten up that clamp on that side, get this guy lined up, push them all the way in, tighten them up. That's going to draw the double E-cam into the closure. Now that we have our double E-cam installed, it's time to cut one of our buffer tubes and then put the slack underneath it. So I'm going to start with taking this out, set it to the side, open this up. This is just a nylon strap to hold it in. Hold your splice trays when you finish. I'm just going to pick blue. Doesn't matter which side I pick. For purposes here, for you, it does matter. Cut the blue. Just going to set that one aside. Now I'm going to make a loop in here. This is however you like to do it. My personal preference is to start back here, fold under, then fold over. Put it underneath the tray supports. Stay nicely down there. Once again, being sure not to kink your buffer tubes. And that's your slack sitting there. Now we're going to put a tray on here, access this, and then we're going to put a single E-cam in there. So for the single E-cam, here are the components. You can see this particular single E-cam comes with four different grommets. You have a single flat, double flat, large round, smaller round. The tools I'm going to need maybe are snips, I'll show you in a moment, quarter inch driver. Once again, we have the tape size to tell me which size I use and which selections I'm going to make. So I'm going to take this tape, wrap it around the end of my cable just to see how big it is. So I'm going to get this, I'm going to try to get as straight as possible, wrap the back side under, and then making sure that it doesn't have any slack, pull it up nice and tight, and then read the numbers. So I have arrows, and you can see this in the instructions, but I have arrows that point across here. What it tells me is to use the smaller of the round grommets, bushing number one, and I need to trim it. And the same thing with the nut clamp, I need to trim. I have two sets of these. One of them has a 2 on the back and a 1, and the other one has a 1 on the back. And this tells me, it told me to use set number one and trim these little tabs right here, as you can see in the instructions, but I'm going to trim these tabs off. To assemble a single E-cam, I'm going to start with the outside portion here. I'm assuming my left, your right is going to be inside the closure. And then I have the smaller of the two grommets told me to put on there. And then this is the inside portion. Now that grommet goes inside, that little washer grommet thing goes inside of this portion here, just like that. Now I'm going to pull this down. Get as much cable as I want on the inside. This is the demo, I'm only leaving a little stub on the end, so I'm going to do that. Get this started. Now, these have a rounded end and a square end. The square end goes up against the closure, or up against the E-cam. Rounded end goes out. One side of this is threaded, the other side is not. So obviously I'm going to put the non-threaded side first. And then put this other side, make sure you got the square end towards the E-cam. Still loose. Just getting it where I want it. And everything's still loose on here. What I want to do now is access some of this cable to get to the central strength member so I can do my strain relief. And then I'll tighten all this up. Once you get it started, you peel it down a little bit. It just opens right up. Trim off that outer jacket. Take this central strength member. Somewhere right around the end there. I'll take my doghouse, strain relief doghouse here. Put it right over the top of that. Get the strain relief nice and tight. Now I'm going to take this, rotate it around until there's no gap between these two. Tighten these up. And take this guy, put him over the top to protect your buffer tubes. Now to install the single ECAM, I have to first of all remove the proper plug. So this is the 12 millimeter plug. So I squeeze those two tabs on the inside, then I can just pull it out on the outside, the buffer tube or buffer tubes, whatever cable you're putting in there. Then I'll put a little lube right here. All right, once again, I like to have the strain relief down. This is personal preference. It will line up inside of there, and on the inside, there's a camming mechanism, which is this thing. It slides over the top of it, and then I push that way. So I make sure it's seated all the way in, and then put that on top of it, and now it's secure in place, and it's sealed in. So now what I want to do is access each one of my buffer tubes to get to the fibers I want to splice, and put any slack. So this particular one, we're just simulating maybe a single drop, so I might cut some of these buffer tubes and then splice to this one. So we'll put a splice tray in here and splice it up. All right, so the last portion here is to route your buffer tubes to the tray. I went ahead and did this. This tray comes with some felt tape. I put that around the larger buffer tubes. On the smaller buffer tubes, like Mini Extend, I use this rubber, this U-channel here. And then you just take the smaller one, you put a little piece of U-channel in there, put a couple zip ties around it, route it inside of here, and same with the larger ones, you put this felt tape around it, route it around inside here, and then you do your splicing. The last thing to do is to put this strap across it to secure it down, and then put the dome on the backside. Now, in all the work you've been doing, it depends upon your environment, you might have to clean this seal right here. If you have some dirt on it, make sure you clean that seal off, put some more silicone on it. Mostly a lube, but it keeps you from it keeps it in place. So now I'm going to take the dome right over the top, push it up, put this cam on there, and it's done. It's ready to go wherever you want it to go.